right? Share file, everything, right? So that's about me. So about today's topic, we are going to have 3 modules on Citrix Application Delivery Management or ADM. To start with, we'll be starting with an introduction. What exactly is an ADM? Now, ADM provides a centralized control, management, and monitoring tool for managing multiple ADCs, application delivery controllers, that is NetScaler, which was earlier known as NetScaler, and also the SD-WAN devices, software-defined wide area networking devices, Citrix SD-WAN devices. Now, managing an ADC itself is quite a time-consuming task, single ADC. That is, to start with, you have to do the initial configuration, you have to publish the applications behind it, provide large number of different features, including load balancing, content switching, content filtering, firewall, gateway, lot many features, almost about 40 different features. Then monitoring it for day-to-day functionality, taking a backup, restoring it, updating it, right, troubleshooting it, right, all that on a single ADC itself becomes a quite a bit of job. And imagine when you have to do it for dozens or maybe even few dozens or hundreds of ADCs and SD-WAN devices. Obviously, it will be a huge, huge, humongous amount of task, and one person will not be able to do it, even if you are spending 24 hours on the Citrix ADC consoles. So ADM provides you a centralized management solution for managing and monitoring and troubleshooting large number of ADC and SD-WAN devices from a single pane of glass, automating multiple tasks so that you don't have to manually repeat it on multiple different devices and so on. So in nutshell, this is what exactly an ADM does. And also it provides you with business intelligence and analytics solutions, right? So that you can plan for the future, prevent failures, prevent recurrence of the failures, right? Capacity planning, viewing the security environment of your SD-WANs and also the ADCs, monitoring the usage patterns, and other such intelligence reports. All that is provided from Citrix ADM. So let's continue. Okay, before we continue, let me give you the agenda for today. As I said, we will have 3 modules. I will we have started with the theory for the first module. Then you can take a quick tea break after this, after the theory is over, and do the lab for first module. I will demonstrate how to do your lab. You must have all received a link for registering for this particular workshop, and the labs are available there. I will demonstrate how to do that lab. So you will do the lab. Then we will take the theory for module 2 and do the lab like that. Most likely by the time we finish the theory for module 2, it will be the lunch time. So we'll take a quick lunch. Let's take only half an hour lunch today. And then we'll complete module 2 labs and then module 3 theory, take tea break, take module 3 labs. And then last half an hour or so, we'll have question and answer session. Okay, so let's continue. So we'll start by describing different features of Citrix ADM. What can it do for us? Why do we need a Citrix ADM? Right? Then we'll see how to deploy on Citrix ADM. What do we need as a underlying infrastructure components for implementing ADM? What are the requirements for implementing ADM? Then after we have installed an ADM, how to carry out the initial configuration, how to prepare it for working, right? And then ADM, as I said, is a centralized management tool for multiple ADCs. Each of those ADCs or SD-WAN devices are known as instances to be managed by ADM. So we'll see how an ADM can connect to those instances, how they can be added to the ADM, and how they can be configured from the ADM console instead of managing it from each of their own individual management consoles or configuration utilities. So Citrix ADM will be able to add multiple instances. We'll have, for our practice, we'll just have only one instance added, but there is no limit. You can have hundreds, thousands instances added to ADM, right? Provided you have enough storage assigned to the ADM. Okay, so let's continue. Right. So introduction to Citrix Application Delivery Management or ADM, right? So basically, as I said, it is a centralized management solution, right? It makes it simple for managing various different day-to-day and long-term operations on ADCs as well as SD-WAN devices, so that administrators can carry out those tasks, right, for the entire enterprise instead of doing it separately on each ADC device or each SD-WAN device. You can centrally do it from ADM. Then there are multiple management jobs which you need to do very regularly. For example, backups, restore, updates, troubleshooting, log management, certificate management. All those things are made available, visible from the entire enterprise. For example, it will tell you which ADC, which certificates are going to expire, where you need to take action to renew them or replace them or whatever. And the task can be executed on multiple instances simultaneously. That speeds up the task execution and also makes the job of an administrator easier. So you can view multiple network services, right? For example, you can view the IP ranges, you can view routes, you can view multiple other features of ADCs, including VLANs, including the performance of each of those virtual IPs, subnet IPs, right? And also the backend applications. One thing I want to clarify here in the beginning itself, when we talk of application in terms of ADC or ADM, we talk of any service which is provided to the front-end users from back-end. For anything deployed behind an ADC is considered an application, right? For example, it may be Microsoft Office, which of course is an application, but it could also be a web application. It could be also a file. It could be a link. It could be other content. Everything is considered as an application. So anything which is deployed behind an ADC, whether it is on-prem data centers or in third-party cloud or within containerized environments on the hypervisors, that can all be viewed and automated. The management of that can be automated by using ADM. Okay. So some of the main features of ADM, application analytics and management. So it might appear to be the just three features, but each of them is actually having a large number of branches, sub features below that, right? So we'll see what different analytics services does the ADM provide to us, what different management features we have for managing backend applications. And as I said, application means anything deployed behind ADC, for which ADC does the management purpose or management task, and ADM manages the ADC managing the applications, right? We do not deploy the applications behind ADM. We deploy applications behind ADCs. But as far as ADM is concerned, every ADC also is an application, because anything deployed behind in the backend network is considered an application. So for an ADM, ADCs are also applications, right? That we'll see as we go further. Then managing various network services, then different configuration tasks, that is creating load balancing, virtual servers, IP addresses, subnet IPs, virtual IPs, policies, right? On multiple instances simultaneously, or replicating it from one instance to multiple instances. Then orchestration. Orchestration is a cloud-based service, which means automated deployment. Because of limitation of time and just having one day, we will not be going into details of orchestration today, but ADM can do this, right? We can deploy SD-WAN devices, we can deploy other instances of ADCs in clouds by using ADM. Okay. Right, so first one. So application analytics and management. First is, there are multiple different analytics which you are going to see further, but two of the most common ones are performance analytics and security analytics. Right, we want to know how is a particular application server performing, how is the particular, and remember, when we say application here, we mean a resource which is deployed behind ADC. For example, virtual apps and desktops, published desktop, published applications, all of them are considered as applications behind ADC. And similarly, for ADM, every ADC is an application. So we can target the individual applications behind individual ADCs or the enterprise-wide deployment of applications, right? And see how they are performing. How are the application servers performing? How are the individual applications performing, right? So some of you must have already worked on Citrix Director, right? Director provides a limited amount of performance analytics for the virtual apps and desktops only. Whereas ADM can provide a much more in-depth analysis of an entire range of applications deployed across your entire enterprise. Then security analytics, any attempts to breach the security. The security includes any access which was unauthorizedly attempted or actually carried out, any unauthorized access, any user trying to access unauthorized content, whether the user is internal or external, right? All that is possible to be done from the ADM. Right. Okay, network and configuration management. Now, different key terms used in this. First is an instance. Instance means any individual ADC or SD-WAN device which has been added to the ADM for centralized management. So individual devices are called instances. Similar instances can be grouped together to create an instance group so that the configuration and other management tasks can be applied to them as an entire group instead of doing it individually on each instance. Right? Event management, that is a log management, right? Gathering the logs from different ADC or SD-WAN devices, centrally manage them, right? Archiving them, purging them, generating reports on them, right? Categorizing them, using them for troubleshooting purposes. Then certificate management, having a complete visibility of all the deployed certificates, right? And their status, whether they are due for expiry or due for renewal, getting new certificates, updating your certificates, right? Creating an enterprise-wide certificate policy where you can specify what should be the minimum key length, which trusted certification authority should be used, and so on. Then configuration management. This is one of the largest tasks, where the entire configuration of ADC devices and SD-WAN devices can be centrally managed and implemented, executed. You can create complete configurations of the entire ADC or a particular feature or a group of features, and then execute it on one or more instances, right? This is the one which will be concentrating on our training. Then configuration audit. Okay, we deployed the configuration on more, one or more instances, but we want to know whether it's successfully deployed everywhere, or also we can see what is the current status of configuration. Do they meet the required configuration standards, or is there something which is different, right? What needs to be done to bring them to the required configuration? All that is configuration audit. Then network reporting, right? The network users, performance, bandwidth utilization, right? Availability of VLANs, routes, and so on. The entire network and different IP address status, right? Reachability, everything is manageable from ADM. Right, then analytics. So analytics is broken into multiple different, that is 8 different insights. Insight is exactly nutshell, insight means you can just by looking at it, you will know how is the particular service or particular feature performing. Web insight is for the software as a service applications, how they are behaving, their availability, their uses, patterns, and so on. HDX insight is for Citrix virtual apps and desktops deployments. Gateway insight is for when we are using a Citrix ADC as a gateway, right? So your VPN performance, your performance of the gateway itself, performance of the virtual servers behind gateway and utility, and so on. Security insight about firewall and other security features of ADC, right? Any violations, right? And any attempts, any breaches of security, right? SSL insight is about certificate utilization, right? Encrypted communication, right? Performance of SSL virtual servers, and also the complete end-to-end encryption performance. TCP Insight is for the software as a service deployed behind ADCs, right? And using TCP as a protocol for access and seeing their performance. Video Insight is again for, it is different from HDX videos, other videos which are deployed behind ADCs, right? For example, video conferencing and so on, and how they are behaving. WAN Insight is for front-end utilization. How are your WAN links functioning, especially for SD-WAN, right? Also, branch to branch or central office to branch performance of your links. Okay, so getting started with Citrix ADM. Right. So first of all, licensing. You can see there's little bit of clarity which is required here. So you can manage and monitor any number of instances and entities without a license. Right, you can manage and monitor any number of instances and entities without a license, but the second bullet point says you can only manage 30 discovered applications on the app dashboard and view analytics data for 30 virtual servers without applying a license. So let us see, we'll be seeing this dashboard later. You have a dashboard and you want to be able to view more than 30 applications or 30 virtual servers on a single dashboard, then you will need a license. If you are okay to keep changing this dashboard for different groups of instances or different groups of applications or different groups of virtual servers, then it's okay, right? You don't need a license. It means you need a license only in case you want to view more than 30 of those applications or virtual servers on a single pane of glass. Now these 30 virtual servers can be on a single ADC or multiple ADCs. For example, there may be 30 virtual servers, right? On a single ADC, you will be able to view only manage 30 of them. Beyond 30 discovered applications or 30 virtual servers, you must purchase and apply a license. Then only you will be able to manage them simultaneously, right? So what does the first bullet point means? So any 30 of them, you can switch between them, but if you want to simultaneously be able to view and manage them, then you will need a license. Also, some of the analytics features require specific licensing. Some of the analytics features which you have seen earlier here, right? For example, Security Insight, right? WAN Insight, Video Insight, they need their own separate licensing. Okay, so system requirements. It is a Linux-based appliance which is deployable on any of the supported hypervisors, including Citrix Hypervisor or Zen Server, VMware, ESXi, right? Microsoft Hyper-V or KVM, right? Now, also it is available as a service in cloud, Citrix Cloud. ADM can be also be licensed as a service on Citrix Cloud. There, deploying it will be the job of Citrix, but managing will be the job of the individual organization. Right, minimum 32 gigs of RAM required, 8 virtual CPUs, Default storage is 120 gigs, which is available during initial installation. It takes 120 gigs of space from the hypervisor. However, you can increase it, but not decrease it later. Right, networking, one interface, minimum of 100 Mbps. Right, you can have multiple interfaces and create a channel out of it, or have a higher throughput required for managing large number of instances. Okay. Minimum required is one interface and minimum 100 Mbps of speed. Okay, so deploying ADM can be done in three different ways. First is having a single ADM, single management node, just one instance of or one single ADM appliance. Used for very small scale organizations for trial or solution development, POC environments, right? Just one is okay. The data is available on the ADM on the included database. When you install ADM, the storage used by ADM is used to create its built-in data repository, and the gathered information from the managed instances is stored in that, right? However, single management node or single ADM can be a single point of failure also. So HA pair is used in most of the smaller and mid-level organizations. So it provides the redundancy. If one fails, the other one is available. Once again, it uses the data repository on the storage, which is with ADM, because it is an HA pair. The databases are automatically synchronized between the two devices or between the two appliances. In medium or large scale environments, you have a scale out kind of management infrastructure, right? You can have multiple different ADMs distributed across multiple different locations, right? And they carry out different specific ADM tasks, right? So functions are distributed. For example, for analytics, you can have in the headquarters or head office. Whereas for instance management, you can have in each branch or each geographical location, right? So this is what we have seen, same thing described in the bullet points below this. Okay, high availability. So when we are deploying ADM in a high availability, we have two ADM instances in a HA pair, each having its local database, right? But synchronized automatically with each other, right? So how do we go about it? We get the ADM image file from Citrix download site, which is our Linux based image. Create first node, right? And then second node and set up the high availability. Now, when we set up a high availability, we must use a load balancer before it so that appropriate node can be automatically selected by using a single URL in the front end, right? Only one node will perform all the functions at any given time, and the other one will be standby. Heartbeats are being exchanged between them, right? And whenever there is a failure in the primary, the secondary takes over. The managed instances are reachable from each of the HA pairs nodes so that each of them can manage all of the managed ADC instances. Okay, so failover of high availability. Whenever any error occurs either the primary servo, that is, when we talk of server, we are talking of the ADM. Loses connectivity to the LAN network, right? For example, here, it loses connectivity to your internal network, right? Or to its load balancer, or any critical software issue or hardware issue like power failure, power supply failure, power cable disconnection, or somebody switches off the power, right? Or that is, primary server is shut down by administrator. So in any of these conditions, secondary ADM will take over. Okay, initial configuration. Sorry if I'm going a little fast, that is because of limitation of time. We have just one day. Okay. Initial configuration. When you power on an ADM for the first time, right, on the hypervisor console, you will get a CLI, command line interface, with a menu based kind of control. For example, Citrix ADM host name, it will provide you whatever is existing host name. Want to modify it, you can provide that. Then select to change the IP address, that is the management IP of the ADM, then the netmask, then gateway, then DNS address. It's important that you provide a DNS IP, because to discover the instances where you are using the host names, to discover the instances, you will need the DNS capability. And then finally cancel or save and quit. You can also do the initial IP addresses from the CLI, and remaining things you can do from the initial configuration wizard. This is reachable from the GUI, from the web interface, right? So initial configuration wizard, right? The screen, this is little older, earlier used to be called as Netscaler MAS, that is management and analytics system. Now it is ADM. So once you have the IP address, you can connect through it from a browser, right? And then manage the remaining things. Whatever has been already configured, for example, network, netmask, gateway, DNS IP, time zone, will show you the green check. Whatever is not configured will be showing you as the orange circle, right? Once you have configured everything, these are all clickable tiles, right? You can click on done. Right. So one of the initial configuration tasks is also configuring the system backup. Now remember, this is the backup of the ADM, not the backup of managed instances. The ADM itself can be backed up, right? And you can specify how many previous backups you want to retain, right? Now these are managed from a backup policy. We are not going to actually cover everything in this module here, but we can create a backup policy and specify the location where it will be backed up. But here you are only backing up, specifying how many previous backups to retain. So depending upon the storage size available, you can choose a smaller or a bigger number. Then whether the backup file should be encrypted, and then whether the backup can be transferred to another ADM instance, right, for restoration. Then by default, backups automatically happen every day at midnight 12:30. This is configurable. Yeah. Then pruning settings. What exactly is pruning? Again, it is controlled by a policy. Pruning means removing all outdated events, audit logs, task logs, those older than 15 days. That is a default setting. You can modify this. You can keep smaller or bigger number. More number of days you want to keep the data, bigger storage you would need, right? Okay, then NTP, network time protocol, is critical that your ADC keeps itself synchronized with the NTP server, because many of the different logs are time dependent, right? So you must have ADMs synchronized from a NTP source, and the same source should be used to synchronize all your ADC instances also. So you can provide the name in case you have the name available and which is resolvable by DNS. Otherwise, provide the IP address, minimum poll interval, and maximum poll interval. That's 4 and 6 is not seconds. It is 2^4 seconds or 2^6 seconds. That means 2^4 is 16 and 2^4 is 6 is 64, right? So any time between 16 to 64 seconds, it will synchronize itself. This you can change to higher number or smaller number as you like, as you want. NTP servers can be reached either by using the non-encrypted communication or by using a key exchange, right? Authenticated NTP server. This is to ensure that no hacker can put up a fake NTP server on the network somewhere and put your entire network out of sync, right? If you say you can set it auto key, it will negotiate every 15 minutes, it will negotiate the key, or you can also make it preferred in case you have multiple NTP servers. This particular server will be preferred server. If this server fails, it will go to the next NTP server.
Hello, sir. Manish here.
Yeah, there's someone wants to ask something.
Yeah, actually, this in NTP server polling interval, minimum we have not 4. So 2^4 is 16. So at every 16 second, it will.
Anytime this randomly. Between 16 to 64 seconds, it will synchronize itself.
Okay, at every 16 or 64 seconds, it will synchronize. It will be
There is a question here from Anil. It says on cloud, we are getting only 2 virtual server licenses. Burhan, I will park this question. We will and PPT, sorry, I cannot share this because this is a confidential PPT. You can see it here, Citrix confidential. However, if you do this course, you will get this in the PDF format. Otherwise, Citrix prohibits sharing this PPT. Okay, let me see some more questions here before we go further. Okay. On cloud, we are getting only 2 virtual server licenses. Let me check. I'm not sure about this for the moment. Burhan, I will answer this question later. Anil, do we need any SQL server? No. No SQL server required. It uses the built-in database of the ADM, right? Can we also configure management subnet IP instead of ADC prior to HAADM setup? Can we also configure management SNP instead of ADC prior to HAADM setup? Now the subnet IP term is used on the ADCs, not on the ADM, right? ADM uses only the single IP for its management, right? That is the management IP of the ADM. right? So because whenever we have HA, we will need the load balancer. So the IP which is used to reach ADMs will be the virtual IP on the ADC. Okay, so let's continue. Instance management. Now you can see that what all instances we can manage from ADM, MPX, VPX, SDX, CPX, right? So we also have the BLX now, that is the bare metal NetScaler. We can see that term used is still NetScaler, although we are calling it ADC now because the PPT is slightly older. It is ADC, MPX, VPX, SDX, CPX, BLX, then gateway. That is in case you are only using it as a gateway, and SD-WAN devices. So these different instances can be added to ADM and managed. Okay, instance group. So instance groups are based on device family. For example, you can have group of MPX managed as a single entity, group of VPX managed as a single entity, and so on. So you can upgrade the entire group, backup the entire group, restore the entire group, right? On the all members of the group, single action can be taken instead of individually managing each member separately. Right. Defining a profile. Now to add the instances, you need to create a profile which ADM presents to the ADC devices for adding them. Give it a name. Then the username password is the username password of the ADC. So in case you are using a common username, for example, NSroot, and a common password on all the instances, you just need one profile. But if you are using multiple different usernames and different passwords, then you would need to create separate multiple profiles. By default, it uses secure shell port 22 and HTTP ports, and HTTPs are used only for containerized ADC for CPX only, right? Then use global settings for ADC communication. That is, instead of using separate profiles for separate ADCs, the settings will be set centrally, right? Then you can also see there are two different ways to discover it. One is SNMP and one is app flow. So if you are using SNMP to discover it, then you specify SNMP version, simple network management protocol version 2 or 3, and the community name, for example, public or whatever. Then waiting time, that is in 2 minutes, the ADC does not respond after reboot, right? It will send the request again, or if it is rebooting, it will wait for 120 seconds before sending the access report, access request once again, right? So of the, once the ADCs boot, they are moved or they are shown as not reachable, and in 120 seconds, it will again attempt to add it back. Or in our lab, we'll find that it is more than 120 seconds. That is because we have limitations of lab, limited amount of resources allocated to lab. So it takes a little longer. However, in your production environments, normally 120 seconds should be good enough. Okay, instance backup settings. Remember previously we have seen three previous number of backup files. Now here it is 2. And backup interval was once in a day, midnight. This is for ADC. Previous one was what we discussed was for ADM backup. This is for every managed instance, the backup of ADCs. So you can password protect the backup file. You can specify should it be backed up, the all managed instances should be backed up every 12 hours or 24 hours or whatever you want to specify. and how many backups should be retained for each managed instance. Once again, it will depend upon how many instances you are managing and how much of storage you have. Okay, then poll interval. Every 30 minutes, as set here, every managed instance will be polled to read either SNMP data or the app flow data about various different parameters, right? Their present functioning, performance, etc. If you have very dynamic environment, then you can set this polling interval to smaller number. In more or less static environments, you can have this poll interval longer. Okay, so that's it, theory for this module. So basically, ADM is a centralized management and monitoring system which provides a very steady, stable and robust tool for managing large number of networking appliances, including ADC and SD-WAN, from a single centralized management console. Right, ADM service is a cloud-based ADM, which provides all the same features which are available on prem ADMs, right? Same functionality. So ADM is a very resource intensive virtual appliance. It means you would need a very good hypervisor on a very good hypervisor, high performance server. Should have enough memory, 32 gigs of it, 8 core processor, right? Good storage capacity, depending upon how many instances you want to manage, and good network bandwidth throughput available. Right, initial configuration wizard is a GUI-based console reachable from web interface, from web console. Right, or you can say from your browser to provide initial parameters like NTP server, DNS, gateway, and so on. Then instances means the different applications. Again, same thing, remember anything behind an ADM will be considered an application. It could be an ADC, it could be a SD-WAN. Right, similarly, anything behind an ADC will be considered an application. It could be a database server, it could be an application server, it could be a virtual app, desktop environment will be considered as an application. Okay, so we have one exercise. Let's take a quick 15 minutes tea break, then I'll come back and demonstrate to you how to do your lab, and then you will do it yourself. Okay, let me see if there is any question waiting to be answered. Is it possible to enable full back with ADM? That is full backup of ADC, you mean? Yes, it is possible. Yeah, you can configure full backup. However, it will again depend upon how much of storage you have with you. How many instances you are managing. Now, see, Naresh will be doing the lab, that time you can check it. You'll be actually doing the lab. Okay. We could only see basic backups. We'll see it from here. You know, whatever you can do from the configuration utility on ADC, you can do it from ADM also. So when you're doing the lab, you'll check it yourself. Okay, so let's reassemble. What is the time now? Time is 10:32. So let's be back at 10:45. Okay. So enjoy your tea. We'll be back in 15 minutes. Okay.
Hello, so I have enrolled for the lab. I just joined the meeting. I was having some heart trouble finding the link. So I was trying to join the link which I got on my, which I got from the Citrix training directly, rather than using the one which was sent on the email. So but, can you help me? I already enrolled for the link that I got. I already enrolled for the lab. So what do I need to do now?
Nitin, are you there? Nitin, you need to activate Jadhav.
So he's already activated.
Yeah, if he's activated, then he will be able to see it. Let me demonstrate that to everyone and then.
And please refresh your that particular site now once again, which are already activated.
Okay. So let's continue with the demonstration part. So you have to log on to training.citrix.com using the same account which you have used for registering, right?
Yeah.
And after you log on the right side on the top, your name will appear. Just click the down arrow, click My Account and Training, right? It will show you are enrolled for CCT 359. Click on Access Materials. And very important, for doing your lab, you will need to have Citrix Workspace app installed on your laptops. Right? It takes just about 5 minutes to install. So I'll show you, in case you don't have it, how to install it. So after clicking on Access Materials, there is Student Resources tab here. Click on it. And you will find three modules listed below that. In my case, it is blinking red. It means my module is already running. That lab is running, but I have not yet launched it. Okay, I'll show you how to do that. So click on the link for the first module to start doing your labs. Click on it. It will take you to a launch screen, and instead of showing you Open Lab in Citrix Workspace app, it will show you a button as Launch Lab. That's all. Okay. It will take 5 minutes for the lab to be prepared. Yeah. What is it?
For me, it's showing as ready to start. So is that the same one?
Click on ready to start. Click on ready to start. Just wait. You can do it after I demo. Yeah, you have enough time after this. So just watch me. So it will be ready to start. Click on that, right?
Yeah.
And it will take 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, the link will change to Open Lab in Citrix Workspace app. In case you do not have Workspace app, right, you can download and install it on your machine, right, by going to the just you can Google for it, Citrix Workspace app, right, and install it on your machines. Right, there is a button here, go to lab guide. If you click on it, it will open another tab here, which is PDF basically. This is the lab guide only for first module. Okay. So this is the lab guide for first module. So let me show you how our lab is built here. This is your laptop or desktop where you are working. When you connect to your lab, you will reach a machine which is known as student desktop, right? Which will be a server 2016, right? Then behind that, there are multiple different machines available. One of the machines is Citrix ADM, right? This has the IP address of 192.168.10.15. You will be connecting to two machines throughout your three modules. Citrix ADC, that is NYC ADC 001.192.168.10.101 and ADM 192.168.10.15. Right, these are the only two machines we'll be using in our first three modules. We are not going to use anything else, right? Okay, so back to this. Well, after 5 minutes, it shows open lab in CTEX workspace app. Click on it, and it will download one ICA file, ICA file. Click on open file to launch your lab. This is what I told you, student desktop, which is server 2016. Let it launch. Yeah. So I'll be doing all your lab from here. Please watch carefully for everyone who has done this earlier. It will be okay for new people. There is a bar on top, toolbar on top. This should read full screen in the middle here. If it is reading window, for example, here like this. Now you can see it is reading window. If it is reading window, click on it to make it read full screen, and then drag your screen such a way that you get both your local machine, your laptop where you are sitting, as well as the remote machine tasks are both should be visible to you, right? So drag it, your local machine and your remote student desktop, both should be, taskbar should be visible to you, right? Now drag your browser close to your lab icon, so it makes it easier to switch between them. Now click on the browser icon and click the lab manual, right? So let us start. These are various, you don't have to worry about this because this particular module is common for other trainings. Right, so let's go to page 8. So here you can read the introduction if you want. We are only have 3 modules for this. Just watch me doing what I'm doing. Exercise 1.1, there is only one exercise in this module, that we are going to carry out the initial configuration of ADM and adding our Citrix ADC VPX to the ADM. That is the only thing we'll do in the first module, right? So it says open Chrome and in tab 1 connect to ADC, and open a second tab and connect to the ADM. So ADM takes little time. If you immediately launch the lab and try to click ADM, it will not connect. It will show either the site cannot be reached or connection refused. Wait for about 4 minutes and then you will be able to connect. So let us open.
Sir, disturbing you in between, but I'm not able to find my training in my portal.
You're not able to find your training?
Yeah, it is showing me older training.
Have you registered for it?
Yeah.
Enrolled for it? What is your name?
Manish Jain.
Nitin, can you please ensure that he is registered and also activated?
Sure, sir. Let me check.
Yeah, okay. So after that, after he activates you, you please refresh your page, training page, and you should be able to see. Right. So within the remote machine, open a Chrome browser and launch ADC001, right? And log on with NS root. Okay. And open a second tab and connect to ADM. Now, because I have spent enough time explaining to you, I can directly connect to it. But when you launch it, initially it will take about 4 or 5 minutes to prepare ADM. Otherwise, it simply says connection refused or site not found. Okay, this also has the same IP address. Same username password, NS root. So log on to both of them. Now please watch carefully, everyone, otherwise you will be finding it difficult to navigate. Scroll down and on the initial welcome screen, click get started. right? Okay, so here it says your lockdown, click get started and click add instance. So here your add instance. So type of instance you need to add is Citrix ADC. So Manish, your lab is activated, you should be able to do that, but do it only after I finish the demonstration. So IP address is 192.168.10.101. Okay. That is the IP address of the instance to add. Okay, click OK. So it'll take some time. It tells you what it is doing. So once it says inventory completed, click close, and now you are having one instance added to ADM, right? So click next. Okay. There it is. Now create a new profile, right? New profile for, basically it is actually not required, you know, why do we not need to create a new profile here in our lab? Reason being, we just have only one instance to be added. Profiles are used when you add multiple instances. However, just for the practice purposes, you are creating a new profile, right? So instance has been added. Okay. Now click add next to profile name and then create. Okay, so you can copy and paste instead of typing everything. Right click and copy. Okay, back to your this, scroll down. Right click next. One second. Okay, we have, in fact, I created, go back. Okay, instance has been added. Click next. Services. Skip. Yeah. Skip and finish. So instance is added. There are a few steps which are missing. So you have to add the new profile. It looks like my lab, somebody has worked on it already. Let me end it and once again open it. Sorry, there is something, it is already pre-configured. That is a problem. So I have to end it. Looks like they gave me a lab, or probably whatever I did was saved already. It should have not been saved. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to end this lab and reopen it. And the lab. Yeah, ready. Yours is also same case. Looks like some labs have been worked already. Okay, so let us start it again. Unnecessary, it is wasting time. Although see, the 2 hours time is given, but the actual time required for this lab is just about 15 to 20 minutes. So ready to start. Start lab. Okay, now you can do it yourself. Start doing it so that we don't waste time. Everyone start your lab, and then once the lab starts, I will demo that and you can follow it.
So Kojit, I just have one question. Do I need to select that specific SF Asia region?
You can, any, if it is already selected, Asia Pacific is okay, but it will work in European Union, it will work in US also.
Yeah, because I selected US because it by default came it like US and I tried to connect to it, but it's not connecting. It's giving me an error.
In Asia Pacific, it was not connecting?
No, in US.
Okay, then choose Asia Pacific.
So do I need to end lab and again start the new lab?
No. If it is showing as end lab, does it show end lab?
It shows. Yeah, it's showing as end lab. It's giving me an option because it's already 10 minutes past. So
it means the lab is there running. Click launch lab. What does it say?
Yeah, I open lab in Citrix Workspace app. I launch the AIKA file. It just gives me error.
And it did not work.
Yeah.
So then end the lab and restart it. Start in Asia Pacific. I don't know what could happen. Why? Okay.
You want me to share my screen and show?
I don't know. I will be able to make you presenter or not. Let me see. Who is it actually? Who is speaking?
Udav Chaju.
Okay. Yeah. So you're the presenter. So have a look. See what happens in the lab. Yeah, okay. Does it time out saying that no servers are available or something like that, that error?
No, just give a reconnection prompt saying that connection interrupted and gives me the error. General error that we get usually while connecting to the desktop, which is probably because of network or something.
Yeah, connection failed with status unknown error. Are you connecting from behind a firewall in your organization?
I'm not connected to VPN. Let me try that
again. It could be that you are behind a firewall or a VPN.
Okay. Let me try disconnecting my VPN, then I'll let you know.
Yeah. Nitin, make me the presenter again here. I can't get it back. Nitin, are you there? Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Done, sir.
Okay, thank you. My lab is about to launch again. There is a question here. Somebody is asking a question. What is it? NS root. Sadek, is the lab guide? It is there. For ADC001, it is NS root. Okay, so we open the AIKA file once again. Now you'll find my IDM will not connect immediately. It takes about 3-4 minutes or maybe a little longer. So ADC will connect immediately, but IDM takes a little time. Okay, if you connect to ADC, you'll straight away be able to connect. NS root. But if you try to connect to ADM, site cannot be reached.
Just one question here. So for ADM, yeah. So is it all already pre-configured? I mean, the initial configuration like the IP setup and the DNS, all these settings are already
done. Yeah, that has been already done. Yeah, you're right. This is because for workshop, we have a very limited environment. This is not a full-fledged training, so we don't have that much of time.
Okay.
Okay.
And also,
so for ADM, it will take a little time. Yeah.
Sorry. So one more thing. So when we add the ADC instance in the ADM, so there are mm-hmm. options like default options like site, the agent, and one more the profile NS profile. So I think we are using the default one. So can you just explain what are those like the agent or the site? What are exactly?
I'll show you. Don't worry. Okay. So ADM will take a little time. By the time I can show you, you go to the Hyper-V manager. And you can look at the ADM status while it is booting. Okay. And also you can connect to ADM directly from here after it is ready. And you will see that initial configuration, what is shown in the PPT, you can do it here. Okay. So login here is NS root. I think this may not be correct for NS root and NS root, it is incorrect. So here, I really don't know what is the login password for this at the CLI level for ADM for our workshop.
So both CLI and NS root is there.
What is that CLI? What is the root? What is the login?
Username is NS root and password NS recover.
NS recover. Okay, let us see. NS root. Yeah, I think in one of the documentation it is provided. No, it is not working. Okay. NS root. NS recover. No, it is not working. Okay. In lab, it's not working. Check. Yeah, okay, doesn't matter. We are not required to go to you can see also it is only 8 GB of RAM, minimal of configuration. Right, okay, so go to the second tab. Now that ADM is booted, still not. Okay, so we'll wait 3-4 minutes.
Actually, it's reverse. Username is NS recover and password is NS root.
Okay. Recover NS root. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's it. So here you can carry out the initial configuration from here itself. So that is providing initial IP and so it is IS config.
Hello Nitin, this is Hari. From where I can get the lab guide? I'm not able to locate it.
I'll show you, don't worry. So in your training, here there is on the left top corner, there is go to lab guide.
Okay.
For each module, the lab guide is provided there. If you click on it, it will open in a new tab. Yeah, I've already opened it here.
Yeah.
It is here.
Got it.
Okay.
Got it. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so let us see if ADM is ready. Yeah, now it is ready. So NS root. Okay, so get started. Right, add instance Citrix ADC or whatever you want to. You can see that different instances which you can add. Then IP address. Yeah, this is where actually I made the mistake. 192.168.10.101. If you are, that's what I was explaining, and then I missed that step. If you are adding only one instance, you don't need to create a profile, right? You have multiple different profiles available, right, for adding different kinds of devices. Here in our lab, we just have just one default profile. You can create new profile by clicking add, right? So create a new profile. So new profile is just copy and paste here. Please ensure that there is no space when you paste it before and after. There should be no space before and after. So NS root, when you copy paste, sometimes the additional space gets added. NS root, right? Remaining everything is to be, except that HTTP instead of HTTPS and SNMP community as public. Remaining everything you leave it to the default values. Okay, so okay, security name is public. Right, HTTP and a protocol for Citrix ADC communication. Uncheck this, use global settings, use HTTP, then you will get this. If you have this checked, use global settings, you will have no option of choosing 80 or 443 for communication with ADC, right? So choose HTTP. By unchecking it, here it is. Clear the use global settings box and select HTTP and enter public, right? So click create. Now you have created a new profile. Although it was not required, why? Because we are adding only one instance. However, if you are adding multiple instances, when the profile runs, it will prompt you with for the IP address, but it will use everything else as a default. Username, password, port, public community, that SNMP community and all. You don't have to type them again and again and again. Okay, ensure that IP address is 192.168.10.101, right? And profile name, whichever you provided in the previous one, right? Site, default site, you are not creating multiple sites here, right? For the moment, only one common site. You can have multiple sites added, right, with different names. For different geographical locations, you can add, create multiple different sites to be managed as a group. Okay. So your ADC has been added. Okay. Click close. Right. Click next. Click skip. Right, you can see that it says skip on the customer identity, click next and finish. next and finish. Another very important thing, you can close this pop-ups, right? Very important thing, your lab guides are not clear on this. Now let us see, it says verify that Citric Acetylamine Delivery Management dashboard is displayed. It is displayed, okay. Switch to tab 1, right? Okay, verify that whatever community you selected on the ADM appears in the ADC also. So here it is, go back to ADC, right? Go to system, SNMP community, go to system, SNMP and community. You will find that the community which you created earlier is appearing here, right? And then system SNMP traps, also verify that it is set to all permission. Yes, it is set to all permission. SNMP traps, it finds, it tells you the destination for generic as well as specific is 192.168.10.15. That is your ADM. Okay. So whatever you did in ADM got added in ADC also. Then airflow collectors, nothing will be there for the time being, right? So system airflow collectors here, airflow as it is nothing, no collector has been added so far. So by default it adds the SNMP as the source protocol, but not airflow. Airflow you'll have to configure later. Okay, so back to ADM, click tiles. Now this is what I wanted to show you. Back to ADM, where is tiles? So this hamburger menu on the right and the left top corner is tiles. Click on it, then you will get the menu, right? Otherwise you can keep searching where it is. Okay, so click tiles, browse to network instances Citrix ADC. So networks instances Citrix ADC, and you will find that 192.168.10.101 is present. Okay, all the instances which you add will be appearing under different tabs here. Okay, so some additional settings, right? System administration, for example, go to scroll down, system administration, and there are multiple different administrative tasks.